never occurred to me, or maybe I didn't think that down. It's not a very, very useful discussion on the very. Now, just to supplement what I was trying to say earlier about comprehensive rules. For example, Priyanka said that she had no idea, it was told that the report was available with the previous, or the RTI was available with the previous PIO lessons with Dr. Now, since we have been clearing the background, it's a common experience that within the period of 2 to 3 years, you know, when we took the first, second appeal has been lingering, the officers get changing. At the moment, there is no RTI register maintained in the department. So, in our, you know, there's a very pre-draft, I won't say it's in the draft stage, but the kind of draft that we try to evolve at Yashra. I mean, I should be very clear because people from the press are there. It is not yet fully under consideration of the government. We said, okay, let it be a brainstorming meeting. We said that each PIO should have a proper register of all the RTIs that are received, giving details, etc., etc., and that should be passed on to the next PIO or next officer, let's say an undersecretary or a desk officer, along with the record that he hands over to his successor. There is always a procedure of handing over and taking over, we all understand, to any organization. So that will provide continuity. So similarly, we discussed many other issues, and we have also said that RTI register should not only be with the PIO, but should also be with the first appellate authority and also with the commission. Commission should also be accountable for what they are doing. And I totally agree that there should be a time limit to decide to decide an appeal. Of course, since the issue of vacancies is always there, perhaps a word as far as possible or, you know, can be included, and probably commissioner, all commissioner, all of us need to put together to justify why we would not discuss within 3 months. I mean, there is no harm. Ultimately, we are all accountable to the sitting of the country. Now, the point which she was saying was regarding public to public signing. Now, see, RTI is totally dependent on the availability or non-availability of the public. Mm-hmm. It's all about disclosing or making the public record transferable. So, public, we have a public record act of 1993 in the government of India, mm-hmm. and we have a public record conformity legislation of the states of 2000. There are public record. Maharashtra public record rules also.
Yes.
But as far as my understanding goes, and I think should be right, the authorities to implement that act are different. That comes with the Ministry of Cultural Affairs and the Government of India and the Department of Culture. Because this is something concerning with the archival records. So one of the points which I tried to put across in some deliberations, even at the Government of India level and over here, I said public record act should be brought within the purview of the GAD. Which is also implementing the RTI, which is also implementing Right to Services Act. Right. Now, there is often a demand that you issue an order that FIR should be lodged, I mean, as part of our order, our directive should be said that FIR should be lodged against the officer who lost the record, etc. Now, I am taking the position, maybe I am wrong, that I am not competent authority under the Public Record Act. I can pass a stricture, no doubt about it, but my powers to impose punishment are confined to section 21 and section 20, subsection 2. So if I say that FIR should be lodged against XYZ PIO, to my mind, I am stepping beyond my jurisdiction. But through the proposed rules, we said, in the rules, one column should be, one rule should say that each and every PIO shall maintain record in accordance with the public record acts. So this provides, to my mind, some kind of an integration. And maybe if not directly, but indirectly, we can catch that. So this would facilitate maybe some kind of a pronouncement that why have you not kept the record, right? So that is one point. Similarly, proactive disclosure. I think Shailesh is the best authority to tell us. At the moment, we don't have a power under 21 and subsection 2 to impose a punishment on the PIO or anybody in the department if proactive disclosure has not been done. As a result, what is happening, many people, and I would say rightly, are asking give us information on 17 parameters. What will they do if you are not proactively disclosing? But that is not the intention. So we, in our draft, we also said each department and each field level of operation shall have a nodal officer who will be declared as a nodal officer for proactive disclosure. Now, we said that at the mantra level or at the department level, he will not be an officer below the rank of a deputy secretary. And at the field commissioner in district, let's put it district, an officer not below the level of an additional director. He could be a additional director of health or maybe whoever, agriculture, DAO, district agriculture, not below the rank of an additional director, shall be the notable officer for proactive disclosure. Now we keep on talking about proactive. I have sufficient time, can I? Proactive is very easy to talk about these 17 parameters. But if you see from the point, let us say PWDs, kinds of roles, it will not fit really into these 17 items. Meaning it has to fit. Meaning these 17 items have to be interpreted by each department. That what do you mean as far as these 17 items are concerned for PWD, for health, for BMC, or for maybe airport authority, etc., etc. Similarly, proactive disclosure at the secretary's level will be very different than at the ground level. A talati or a patwari is not supposed to disclose on all the 17 items like revenue secretary is supposed to. So therefore we said, the nodal officer shall, in consultation with his colleagues or with some kind of a committee in each department, A, define what kind of proactive disclosure under section 4.1b is required at the department level, at the HOD level, director level, director of health, director of whoever, education, and at the field level, at the district level, at the director or district education officer, and down below at Patwari, Gram Sevak, or maybe a health worker, whoever is the PM. That for the quality and content of proactive disclosure will differ from department to department and level to level. Similarly, we have also proposed that at the department level, when I say mantra level, it has to be digital, no doubt about it. They are both aware of that, and there is no justification, particularly in Maharashtra, to say that we cannot do it. Similarly, at the HOD level, when we say HOD in state government, we talk about directors or commissioners, right? It could be the revenue commissioner, it could be commissioner of that, etc. It has to be digitized. However, at the ground level, maybe ground saver or whatever, if possible, digitize it, but it should be in the form of a board, informational board, or through printed material. So, those points we have included in the rules. Now, you can challenge that we are probably going beyond the provisions of RTI, but to my mind, it's not contradictory, but it's complementary to the RTI. So, these two things we have definitely tried to propose. And in fact, I would request if Governor of Maharashtra agrees, we have complete draft in place. We can have a discussion and some kind of a round table also. But then, you know, what we did was an academic exercise. I'm not that authority to prepare rules. The rules have to be prepared by the Governor of Maharashtra, like DOT. These rules are not of the Central Information Commission, but of the DOT. Right? So it is the Governor of Maharashtra to decide whether to deliberate, because it has not been notified even in draft state, right? The very kind of thing. About digitalization of procedure, I totally agree that as far as possible, we should digitalize the entire procedure. Of course, there are network issues, there are internet issues. I mean, WannaCry is a different issue, or ransomware is a different issue, but normally also, we have internet problems. Even Mumbai at times, the speed is quite.
That's why I have to say that.
But having said that, ultimately, that's also improving side by side, you know, different players coming into the game. Or what we have proposed now, the thing that now online RTI has started, we all agree, but for a person in a village, it is next to impossible. For two reasons, because of his literacy level and because of non-availability of the network. But we have these central common services centers all over the country and for that matter in Maharashtra. Practically in each Gram Panchayat, there is a common service center who are providing a number of services including reservation, this certificate, that certificate. And I have written to GAD long back that if you simply add a word, those services will include RTA also. So those people who are self-employed people running some kind of a usually old word, cyber cafe is not the right word, but some kind of a cyber cafe, they can, if the person wants, if he is ready to invest another 10 rupees, which to my mind is not a huge amount these days, he can approach the cyber cafe, the CSE, sorry, not the cyber cafe, the CSE, and say, I want to see the websites of the government, what all has been disclosed. And he can be charged say, 5 rupees per hour or whatever. And that person can guide him, take him through the whole labyrinth of the website and come to the conclusion. Now it's not easy for me also at times the document don't open. It's a fact of life. And also helping him in filing an online application. So you give a choice to the citizen. A, if he doesn't want money at all, doesn't matter, let him write a provisional way, take an application, but if he wants to file online, he should have an opportunity to do that. At the commission, at the government level, even first, in many departments, first appeal online is being accepted. We have also started an initiative, and I think within a month, our batch to begin with will have online second appeal, digital online facilitation. We are working with both NIC as well as Maha Online, which is a joint venture of the government and TCS. And we have by and large followed the CIC software. So once that is done, it will be step. Once it is successfully launched in our bench, then naturally it will be applicable to the entire system. So people will be able to file the second appeal online, and I entirely agree with whoever it's a big or allergy proposed video conference. As far as possible, we should enter a video conference so that people don't have to travel. I know getting excellent the chairman being here, the chairman to railway board. Still getting railway reservation on going forward and coming all the way to Mumbai, etc. is not a very pleasant thing for a small piece of information. So we'll also have taken a note of it and we'll try to tie with the collectors rather than calling them up to Mumbai. We can request them to go to collector's office. At least rather than coming to Mumbai, if they go to district headquarters and the city headquarters, yes. We can have discussion or hear them on the video. Yeah, that can also be an additional fear. Now, the last point is that about the withdrawal. I think a very good point that withdrawal could be under duress, and that information in any case should be brought under public domain. So probably what can be that even if the case is withdrawn, I'll follow it now immediately. We'll say that, okay, give me a copy of the information that you're doing. So at least the information will come out. Even if the applicant says that, okay, I have withdrawn, I'm happy, okay, we'll say, fine, give me a copy of this or the AO will give me. And then we can probably upload it along with the order. But here is the information attached along with this order. So I think that. My response was pretty long, sorry.
Sir, you are the main person.
Just one of the things while Mr. Jain was talking,
yes,
that occurred to me. There is a provision for return of appeals in Mumbai. But I think there should be a time limit. My own sense of it is more than 30 days sound unreasonable. Should be 15 days or 30, but no more, and I think that should be part of the recommendation that we make. That the Commission cannot send back appeals or complaints after 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, because then the whole purpose gets lost.
Right.
And secondly, on compliance, a thought came by Mr. Jain was speaking. It could be part of the rules that when an order is not complied with, the Commission shall order compensation to be paid to the applicant. Because when the Commission's order is not complied with, I think there must be some mechanism. First, the citizen is harassed by the time he gets his first decision. And then, if the order is not complied with, right now, it's open-ended, you know, you go back and try and prove. I think it should become mandatory that the commission must, it may be 1,000 rupees or 2,000 rupees, I'm not talking of great compensation.
Maybe actuals. Maybe actuals.
No, actuals is far tougher. Sandeep, but some amount, 1,000 or 2,000 rupees, if it becomes parts of the rules, I think it will be very useful and it will ensure better compliance with the commission's orders. Whether it's been complied with or not is the commission's decision. Nobody else is going to decide. But I think when there is a non-compliance, there should be a salutary effect. Bhaskar, you wanted to say something.
See, basically, I want to pertain to the rules which are the compliance to the information commission's orders. At present, every time it is said that we, even at the Information Commission level, the PIO has to, they give an order that compliance report be provided to the commission. Now there is no machinery to see at the commission level how to compare the whether the commission's compliance is done. So that's a big hitch over there. And the other is that the complainer coming back to the commission, what is the time limit that the commission will address that non-compliance? Because as the rules are for all over India, see, maybe that
service report is only for
central. No, central government, as the rules are for the central government, the response time of the non-compliance, if it takes around say 3-4 years, then how the compliance things will be followed? When you go to the commission and say my compliance is not done, the response time from the commission for non-compliance, that needs to be a time limit. Whereas that's what I said, that these rules are only obligated to the applicant, to the PIO, but for the commission there is nothing. So I feel that there needs to be, if the commissions are drafting the rules, they should also have a self-discipline to be recommended. Otherwise it will be very difficult for the implementation.
Can it be said in the
I just want to ask, say one more, that about this section 4. You said as per the department level. Sir, we did the same thing at the municipal corporation when the Right to Information Technical Advisory Committee was formed. We recommended at the lowest level what should be the section 4. If you see in the municipal corporation's websites, we have given a model section 4 at the sectional head level. That means assistant engineer maintenance, assistant engineer building. We have not gone above that level. Even that is not implemented in all the wards. If that is published, I think here the 90% of the applications will be less. We are not gone to the department level.
I think our recommendation was based on this experience.
So it took me 6 months to sit in one ward. I sat a day there, daily speaking to an assistant commissioner, assistant engineers, talking about there, and we made it, but still that model is not good. So I would appreciate if the Maharashtra Commission takes cognizance of it, gives directives to the head of the department to implement it.
Incidentally, on this, sir, I must concede, I'm chairman of this technical advisory panel. We have won in over 40-45 meetings. I have not been more ineffective in my entire life as I have been as chairman of this technical advisory. But okay.
My suggestions can be said in the rule. If the information commissioner would be not obliged to pass by passing an order directing the PIO to publish information and file compliance.
See that?
Yes, if I need to comply, that it has been punished. A letter to that effect.
No. My problem is when you talk of adding anything to the commission's role.
So,
to my mind, a lot of commissions may not mind. They will say, "Tum bolega, wo hum karega." There are commissions who, for example, in Karnataka, have this continuing mandamus. They say, "We are ideal. We have a continuing mandamus." The point is, ultimately, it slows down the whole process. And I would be very happy if we could have time limits for the commissions, but I don't see that happening. Our judiciary is such an outstanding example, and I don't think commissioners also think. Certain commissioners think of Supreme Court ke judges hai, to wo ye karte hai, to hum kyon nahi kar sakte?
Yeah, I don't understand.
No, sorry, I do not understand. Compliance, what I am saying is, it means commission must look at the compliance.
No, it will not look into the compliance. See, it would be the responsibility of the PIO or the FA to inform by a letter only that the directions have been complied with, and it would be fine. If it's a general, that would be a responsibility.
Okay, you're right, disagree, Sandeep. There is a statutory order. It has to be followed. There is no need for somebody to come like a monitor. If there is non-compliance, that is what I am suggesting, there should be mandatory in the rules itself that there will be a compensation.
That's a different thing altogether. Because nowadays, even the high courts are also passing orders and stating in the order that the authority should file compliance. That's all. It could be said.
Can I? There are two issues for compliances. First of all, we should monitor compliance ourselves, right? Say you said the PIO should report the compliance back. Or what is the mechanism whereby one can understand whether compliance has been made or not? Now, what is presently happening is, A, when the information is not received by the querist or by the applicant or dependent, he comes back with a complaint. Now, rightly or wrongly, we are entertaining it as a complaint under Section 18.
Correct.
Right?
Absolutely.
And there, we also go ahead and we follow by and large the detailed process and then say, okay, my fine should not be imposed. We, of course, we have never ordered compensation because that is part of Section 19.8 or whatever 9. So that is mentioned, compensation is mentioned in the appeal provision. It's not mentioned in the complaint provision. So that's one. This is not compliance of that thing. I mean, we are hearing from the person who wants information that I have not received this fine, number one. Number two is that wherever we file, wherever we propose a fine, say, okay, give information by say 30th of May or 31st of May and explain why action under 21, 1 or whatever, 21 or 2 should not be taken. Now that we follow, right? In the sense that if compliance, if the explanation has not been given, then we say that then we will impose penalty. However, I must say that because we had good backlog, my own case, I clear, as I said, I'm now trying to self-praise about almost 13 to 14,000 appeals during the last 3 years. As a result, what happened? We couldn't get time to look into those compliance cases. Now I am clearing during my vacations now, I am focusing on the compliances which I had ordered in 2008, 2015, 2016. Today, after most, I have kept the hearing for that. But that is very essential, and then unless that happens, the orders of the Commission will not be taken seriously at all. So ultimately, you know, when you talk of your suggestion is somehow the higher delegation, that all compliances should be reported. The problem is that we are also unable to RTI anything. Somebody will say, I have not ordered information, give me a copy of the compliance report given by the PIO. And you see, again, that is not only an RTI, that is also first appeal. I have to hear, or maybe some other bench has to hear. So we go into complex procedure, let's not do that. As said, continuous mandamus, somebody also probably Karnataka did this thing. They didn't close the appeal unless the compliance was done. Well, that is ideally impossible, but again, you know, disposal of the appeal is equally important. So to my mind, the best thing is that let's assume that compliance has been done, and if a complaint is heard, then in complaint our attitude is very harsh towards the PIO. We don't let it.
Then it could be that it must be heard in priority.
Now we are, I mean, now my complaints have also come down to 300, only other 300 also.
Huge number. Complaints in respect of non-compliances.
Sorry, non-compliances key.
No, I think what Sandeep is saying again makes sense. Instead of compensation, it could also be that non-compliances must be heard in the market. Because then the commission's statutory power is reinforced, you know, if people feel ki hum nahi karenge
to sab. There should be some type of a faster mechanism for non-compliance.
Now the time has come, complaint should be given a little more priority to my mind. I mean, non-compliance.
To the extent of non-compliance, there could be a category of non-compliance.
मेरा ऐसा सुझाव कि जैसे डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल में कि आज भी इंफॉर्मेशन कैसे मिलने चाहिए, जैसे पीएम जी ने भी बताया, लोगों को पता नहीं. तो अगर गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से हर डिस्ट्रिक्ट जैसे कलेक्टर ऑफिस होते हैं और अगर इंफॉर्मेशन सेंटर बनाएंगे कि लोगों को क्या चाहिए, क्या उन्हें जानकारी चाहिए, जैसे पुणे में यदि महेश जल्दी कमिश्नर थे, उन्होंने एक छोटी सी लाइब्रेरी बनाई है और सभी इन्फॉर्मेशन उन्होंने प्रोवाइड कर दी है विदाउट आईटीए. जैसे अभी नई मुंबई में भी सिडकू ने भी वो प्रयोग शुरू किए हैं. तो आरटीए के बिना भी अगर आपको कोई डॉक्यूमेंट चाहिए तो गवर्नमेंट को डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल में या कमिश्नर जो जैसे पुणे महानगर पालिका, मुंबई महानगर पालिका, वहाँ पर ऐसा एक सेंटर बनाना चाहिए कि जो डॉक्यूमेंट आपको चाहिए आप आइए, जो यहाँ पर अवेलेबल है वो आपको देखने को मिलेगा, और जो चीज़ें नहीं है उसे दो चार दिन में हम प्रोवाइड करेंगे, नंबर वन. सेकेंडली, अभी जो पब्लिक इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफिसर और फर्स्ट अपीलेट ऑफिसर, दो इश्यूज है, क्योंकि फर्स्ट अपीलेट ऑफिसर को किसी भी तरह का फाइन नहीं है. जब हम पब्लिक इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफिसर इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं देता है तो हम फर्स्ट अपील करते हैं, उसके बाद सेकेंड अपील करते हैं. पर फर्स्ट अपीलेट ऑफिसर का सीरियस होगा क्योंकि उन्हें किसी भी तरह की सजा का प्रावधान फिलहाल एक्ट में नहीं है. तो कई बार पीआईओ को कहने के बावजूद भी वो इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं देते हैं, सेकेंड अपील की संख्या बढ़ रही है. तो फर्स्ट अपीलेट ऑफिसर को अगर इसमें प्रावधान करेंगे उन्हें कुछ ना कुछ सजा होनी चाहिए, कुछ फाइन होना चाहिए, तो कहीं ना कहीं तो पीआईओ पर प्रेशर बनाएगा। और जब 2002 में महाराष्ट्र में जब इंफॉर्मेशन एक्ट आया तभी हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पब्लिक इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफिसर होते थे। आज मुंबई में जो असिस्टेंट इंजीनियर जो पब्लिक इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफिसर और अपलेट ऑफिसर एग्जीक्यूटिव इंजीनियर है। इससे पहले डब्ल्यू जो वार्ड ऑफिसर होते थे वो पब्लिक इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफिसर होते थे, तो उस वक्त फास्टली इंफॉर्मेशन मिलती थी और प्रेशर होता था। पर हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट के जो प्रोसेस होते थे डीएमसी के डायरेक्टर ही इज द फर्स्ट अपलेट ऑफिसर। पर पिछले 7 से 8 सालों में खास महानगर पालिका में उन्होंने उस पद को डाउन करते 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 कभी ऐसा हो पाएगा किसी चपरासी को भी लोग इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफिसर बना देंगे, क्योंकि जो पोजीशन जो डाउन टू चल रही है। तो इसे कहीं ना कहीं तो सुधारने के लिए सजेशन भेजने चाहिए कि जो परफेक्ट ऑफिसर हो, जो पीआर को सब जानकारी हो, उसी को आप इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफिसर बनाइए। कई बार क्या होता है कि जैसे मैं पिछले 10-12 साल से एप्लीकेशन करता हूँ तो कई बार उसे पता ही नहीं होता कि फाइल हमारे पास है, जबकि ही तो पब्लिक इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफिसर। तो विदाउट नॉलेज नहीं होने की वजह से भी अपील की संख्या बढ़ती है और कमीशन पर भी बर्डन होता है। तो निचले स्तर पर अगर हम इसकी कुछ सुविधा करते हैं, कुछ प्रावधान करते हैं, तो निश्चित तौर पर कहीं ना कहीं तो जो फर्स्ट अपील और सेकेंड अपील की संख्या में हम कमी ला सकते हैं।
इसके अंदर जो पब्लिक रिकॉर्ड्स एक्ट में जो पर्टिकुलर अथॉरिटी है जो ऑफिसर जिसको अपॉइंट करता है, इफ ही कैन बिकम द पीआईओ, आई मीन सजेस्टिंग
इट इज एज पर द बीएमसी एज पर द सर्कुलर पीआईओस आर द पब्लिक रिकॉर्ड।
ओके, आई वाज नॉट दैट
इज द आंसर।
या यस,
ऑफ कोर्स द आंसर इज दैट इज डन बाय ऑल डिपार्टमेंट दैट इज रिजॉल्व 90% ऑफ
द दैट्स इट। आई जस्ट वांट टू शेयर हियर दैट द I just want to share the, as you said, I know that there is a charge taking and charging and a record also taken. I feel that all commissions should now say, I think, because record maintenance is the major issue, or all commissions should say that this should be a Section 4 matter and everything should be published on the website. What are the records taken by the record managers? And what are the records given? If that is forced upon, I think the most of the records will come on the section. So that is, the people also will know that he will not be having a chance to say that my files are lost, my files are lost. That's what I feel. And this is a section 4. जो भी charge लिया जाता है, एक आपकी PIO जो भी दूसरे से charge लेते हैं, तो they take it the documentation. It is not happening in the public authority is a different matter in itself. But if he can force on this, I think the many of the matters will come into and many of the things which are not there. That means the PIO, sometimes PIO is doesn't know also whether the records are there or not. He only pages it out and then he comes to know that the records are. So मुझे लगता है कि ये एक record management है main मुद्दा है कि इस चीज में अगर importance दिया जाए तो मुझे लगता है कि ये ज़्यादा ठीक होगा. I feel that there should be a recommendation because commissions won't be able to work properly if the records will not be able to bring the accountability if the records are not maintained properly. Record Maintenance Act is most, and there is also jail term of 5 years and a penalty of 10,000 in record management.
But that is more applicable to, frankly speaking, archival record, old record which has to be maintained permanently.
Yes.
Whereas most of the queries are pertaining to the current record.
Yes.
That is
right.
To my mind is not really addressed by the public.
Yes, that's what I said. You see, when the bifurcation of ABCD records, which is there, if permanent records, all those records, if they are there, then I think the moment the charge taking and charge giving, if that all details are uploaded on the website, even if the record is lost or if record is destroyed, that detail has to be recorded. And that also needs to be provided to an applicant if they say that record is destroyed. So, I think the commissions need to take this under on this matter and come out with some issues.
I think we have had a very good discussion. I mean, so after very long, I retired 6 years ago. So up to now, finding a lot of changes have come because I handled RTI for nearly 6 years before that, 2005. A lot of information is being given. I find in Railway Ministry, we have a lot of information on the website.
Yes.
We just click there and a lot of it is coming. We started that. way back, and now we are able to do our research work also without reaching them. When we are clicking in the website and getting information in statistics and other details. So very rightly, Ajit Jainji has brought out certain matter, and I think that automatic revealing of information without any RTI application is also a subject which should be now considered by all the intelligence or civil society of the country. It should be automatic. It should be put on the website. Every department should have a website where, even if you don't know the department, you keep on surfing for 1 or 2 hours sitting at your home, and you are able to retrieve the information. How that can be done, that is something which will, you know, pay forward.
That, sir, I believe is extremely simple. If the government decides to banish paper files and go only for digital working, which is not a difficult problem to choose.
It may not be made available to public.
No, why shouldn't it be? Everything you do on a computer,
government has its own way. So the they have to make it public.
The nation has to have a way. The government must follow what the nation needs. It is not the other way around. The
nation wants to know.
Yes, anyone has? Otherwise, we will.
About the railways that you said, I have been following up the expenditure part and the services part of the railways. And we campaign a lot in railway about the items that are given as service and the food products. You will see that these details about a tea charging ₹5 is still not available on the website. And we pay ₹10. And we do the social audit, we tell the passengers, and then we sleep at night, but the passengers fight out with the contractors, because that's the way we do it. So transparency is there where there is a revenue to the railways. Transparency is not there where the citizens get involved. I agree that a lot of things. If a railway ticket, in which counter, how much revenue has been generated, with a click of a button, if the Western Railway can know, in that much is the fastness, then this also should come out. So this is lacking. So I would like to network with the railways to make this type of transparencies, and I think that will be a better thing. So
maybe after this.
Yes, that's what I said. That's why I put it out.
I will not take further.
Yes. One important measure which I think we should appreciate in these draft rules, which perhaps nobody has touched on, there is a provision for a complaint to be converted into a second appeal during the hearing. To the best of my understanding, this is an attempt to overcome a regressive Supreme Court order on complaints and appeals. It's really regressive. Of course, some people have told me this will be thrown out by the court. If it goes to court, I can see. Because the court said whatever we say is right, but I think it's a good attempt of DOPT to get around this difficulty where in a complaint no information can be given. So I would really applaud that.
Yes, I think very quickly, before we wrap up, the one thing that Mr. Jain brought up, and that was something that everybody around the table appreciated, that we need to have some sort of review system for the decisions that are given out by the second appeal. Now, to begin with, I think I want Jain sir to elaborate a little more on this, followed by maybe a legal perspective by Mr. Jalan, who can tell us how we can introduce this review procedure in line with the review process that we have for criminal cases or civil cases. So can something on those lines be possible, and then maybe we can throw it open to the others as well to weigh in on this, but how a review system can be put in place for the orders passed by the commission.
See, a review in general, and whether provided in the Act or not provided in the Act, I mean, so motor revision or review, whatever, it takes place only when there is an apparent error of law. And with all very fundamental error in understanding the facts, appreciating the facts, which if not corrected will lead to miscarriage of justice either way. Either it's the RTI applicant or when any of the parties to appeal. Now, normally all courts or tribunals, they have these powers, inherently they have the powers to kind of correct it. So, when I say there should be a provision of review, it definitely doesn't mean that you reopen the entire issue.
Yes.
Otherwise, that will lead to plethora of review applications which will be unmanageable. But for example, the appellant says that I never said or my application was there that I have not given the been provided with this information. And suppose it has not happened, but hypothetically, if I say that he has given in writing that his information has been received. So this is apparent contradiction and the factual position. This is a good case for review. Or if I say that, okay, I impose a fine of 25,000 or whatever amount on the PIO, and he says that I was not PIO at all. The other person was PIO. Now, in fact, this is another very major problem that we face, and a simple solution to, I mean, you don't know who was the PIO in 2012-2013, or maybe the PIOs have changed because of reorganization, as Mr. Gargali said, that earlier senior officers were the PIO, not junior officer. Simple solution in this case, like I said, from the point is that there should be mandatory that when reply is given, PIO should write his name, designation, and signature. Invariably, they are not doing it. Probably deliberately. There simply signed AKJ, AKJ put the number of person, AKJ also could be there, or some other person could also be there. And then it's very, very difficult to pinpoint who is the defaulting PIO. So, well, coming back to the point, if the PIO said that, Toki Nagi, I was not the person, then naturally you have to reopen the case and say, if there is a case, then you do something. So, review should be limited, only set rightly at.
The painting errors, we call it in the legal speak, sir.
We are actually recording this painting.
Yeah. Sir. As the sir is right, sir.
Hello.
As the sir has rightly pointed out, the expression would be the error apparent on the face of the report. Those things could be reviewed by the commission. And although in review in general in civil litigation, it does include some more other things, but then in my view it should not be included in this other way as sir is rightly said, or the people will come again and say that it has not been considered, it has this is not been considered. It should be confined to errors apparent on the face of the record.
My submission is errors apparent on the face of the record does not need a review power. You don't need a review power for that. As the courts themselves have said, apparent errors of fact can be corrected. And I would like to submit that in search of perfection, we don't even get good quite often. My worry is about loads and commissions. I would say the first priority if RTI Act has to survive is that commissions must dispose in 30 days. And across the nation, it's not happening. The Central Commission is today disposing matters after 1 year or 1.5 years. And this is a continuing trend. And by and large, except the Maharashtra Commission, the other commissioners don't care at all. So to my mind, our first priority must be to say, we will not increase the load on commission, but we want a commitment that it should finish in so much time. You know, anything additional, it may look very fine, but you damage the system.
Prabhu sir wanted to weigh in. Actually, we have given one recommendation. We had a CHRI meeting on this, that there is a clarifying of locus of appeals under section 99. So I appeal against the decision of the commissions under section 19 that we have set of the Act, and further appeal against the decision of the commission shall lie before a group of three or more commissioners, as the commission may collectively determine, and any or all the following conditions are satisfied. So that was the review which we had done. But Maharashtra Information Commission have been following it up with sometimes a durustikar. I think most of the time, I think that is also a better system. It's not a full change of the order, but when the facts are brought in front, then durustikar is done. But we had recommended, if it is a very larger issue as such, because it's not a judicial review. It's a review of the order given by the commission. We have recommended this to include in the draft rule. So this all drafts that we have given to be forwarded by email to you. So there are 27 pages.
I would again reiterate, at the cost of repetition, activists and users quite often become the death knell of a law. desire and fairy tale of a perfect society leads into a very poor society. I keep repeating, Central Commission, they will accept whatever we say. Let's assume for the moment they accept all of this. And your time period becomes 2 years instead of 3,000 which they are disposing in a year. They will say we dispose 2,500. What would happen to RTI? Therefore, I think we need to consciously understand that keep the commission road down, ensure speedier disposals.
So there should not be any review.
My submission is there should not be. Except, as you said, Durusti Karan.
And in fact, instead of review, I mean CPC, Civil Code Procedure Code, we call it amendment, then omissions, unintentional omissions, arithmetical errors, these could be addressed instead of review. I mean, it's a very serious thing, the load of the commission. That's very good. Because everyone otherwise would say it's an error happened on the face of the reform. And it would only be revealed in the hearing only. Whether it's an error, it has to be decided. Then it's a very risky affair.
So, to summarize, then maybe something where you have a provision that there has been an error of fact in terms of a mathematical error, like you pointed out in CPC, but not calling it review so as not increase the load of the commission.
But then that doesn't need any change in rules. I mean, see, this is a dangerous game we play. You put it in that, they term it as review.
That's correct.
Yes.
It is inherent. As he says, Maharashtra Commission is doing Durusti Karan.
He doesn't require
everything. Is. I mean, clarity is not always desirable.
Alright, so I think we're pretty much towards the end. There are a few people from the media and students who've come here. So if any of them would like to ask a question, maybe we can very quickly take two questions.
Okay, I've got one hand up here.
Right, first one here. Excellent. Just also introduce yourself.
My name is Ashutosh, I am from DNA. Repeatedly, information commission reports have said that first appellate authorities do not decide the applications properly, which is why they come to second appeal stage. So in the rules, no one has till now pointed out if there is a possibility of a first appellate authority to be fined. Do you think if it's possible, if it is not in the law, can it be enacted through the rules?
No, the answer is no.
Why?
It has to be in the law. It cannot be put in as rules. And for God's sake, don't say let's change the act, because then we are dead.
Quick second question is, with respect to clubbing of the acts, we reported about certain commission orders when acts were clubbed different. Like Records Act. So, if a PIO is not the record officer, shouldn't the dean PIO in that case be looked upon as the officer and the action should be taken against that person?
My answer is yes. Suppose if the officer concerned is or PIO is different, the record keeper is someone else. Now, let's take an example, collective. As they call traditionally a huzoor record room, and the old record, revenue record is concerned, it is kept by the record keeper. We very often have a senior number. So we are treating him as a deemed PIO. Now, since I am handling this particular department, I keep getting requests of documents of 1950, 1930. So they are inherently more than a call. So yes, the record keeper is supposed to be.
I'm Vedant Khanna from the Hindu. I had a question which is generally open to the panelists at large. It was about formally ruled 10(1) in the 2012 draft proceedings. I could read it if need be, but it has been deleted from the 2017 draft.
Just read that.
Yes, sir. The rule was with respect to process of appeal. It read, on receipt of an appeal, if the commission is not satisfied that it is a fit case to proceed with, it may, after giving an opportunity of being heard to the appellant and after recording its reasons, dismiss the appeal. That is the rule that was in force in the 2012 draft, 2012 rules. It has been omitted in the 2017 draft, and it grants a level of arbitrariness that can be dangerous to the commission. It can be used to quash or quell appeals that that could perhaps be considered dangerous for vested interests or individuals higher up chains of power. So I would like a comment by any and all panelists, especially Jensa, if possible, on the issue.
I think if that rule, I don't really, I have not seen it rightly, but if that rule is not there, so that becomes a redundant issue. And in fact, that provision should not be there at all. However, when you talk of a complaint, you know, all the under Section 18, there is a provision of kind of first verifying the record, getting, you know, details, whether it, I mean, ascertaining whether information has been given or not. All appeals have to be heard, number one, but all complaints need not be inquired. So there's a difference between Section 19 and Section 18, but I agree with you, such provision should not be there.
So can I ask a question?
Yes.
I don't want to go there.
Off the record.
Gandhi sir, information commissioners से खिलाफ बहुत सारी शिकायतें जाती हैं regarding their less attendance and all. So how you are working on this issue?
When I was in the commission, I proposed a citizens charter, and I'd be happy to share it with everybody. Initially, the chief commissioner was slightly enthusiastic, but they said one meeting, second meeting, and ultimately the other commissioners said, "Nahi, we don't want a citizens charter." And my suggestion is, the solution lies in us forcing information commissions and all such regulatory bodies to become more transparent and accountable themselves. Because if you don't have that, we need a role model. Where is our role model for transparency? It's not the courts, unfortunately. In fact, courts, in my opinion, are one of the lower ranking people in terms of the RTI Act and disclosures. Commissions, by and large, have not been role models. But I think we should make an effort, all of us together, to make the commissions more accountable. Because then we'll at least have a role model which can be, we can tell others, you do like this. Until that happens, we have a problem.
Sir, so far I recall that you tried to be a role model by declaring all your personal assets. So nobody else followed that?
The commission has to. I mean, it's individuals doesn't make much of a difference. The commission has to become a role model for transparency.
But what happened to the idea that you disclose all your personal assets on the website or somewhere else, but nobody followed you, so...
No, that's not true.
Don't suggest for the review. I'm afraid. Don't suggest for the review jurisdiction of the commission. I'm very so much pendency.
In Pune, it is Pune thing. Match it every 14,000.
Although it sounds very good to have a review.
There have been different viewpoints, which is good. I think that's the essence of democracy, in my opinion. If there are no differing opinions, then it means it's a bunch of sheep. He's repeating that everything is fine. I am sure Observer Research Foundation will take this further, and I'm also hoping that you will take up other things on RTI, not just the rules. And I'd like to thank all of you. I don't see a need for summing up because it's difficult to sum up such diverse views. Hopefully, Dilip is capturing that and he'll report. But as far as I'm concerned, I think all of you have been a fantastic panel. And my thanks to all of you. Thank you very much.